What that? The pulse beat of this cosmic universe. A planet revolves on its axis. It faces the heat of its sun. And the very pattern of a circle, beginning nowhere, ending nowhere, like life itself. Have you seen the great symbolism of the circle? The circle that has no beginning, has no end. No story of creation necessary. No fables such as God resting on the seventh day, he was so tired at the end of the sixth. But a great millions of years history for you, of worlds turning on their axes, spinning in their elliptical orbits around their flaming suns, with a regularity that brings a pulse beat of day, night, spring, summer, autumn, winter, spring, summer, autumn, winter, waxing moon and waning moon and waxing moon and waning moon, ebb tide and flow tide and ebb tide and flow tide. Movement. Movement! Did you ever know a dead thing to move? Where is there death? Must you still have love from Aunt Mary to prove there is no death? Can't you grow? Can't you know the call of the God within you to the grandeur that makes you forever forget? You're born and conceived in sin. Your righteousness is as filthy rags. You know our challenge. You've heard it so often. This come up higher, higher yet, higher yet. It is for eyes of the soul as well as the body to observe the rhythm of cosmos. Now, just to take your eyes away from that pattern for a moment and take you to the first letter of the alphabet of a parallel philosophy that will fit the phenomena. May we remind you of the existence, wherever you turn, of the law of opposites. You need go no farther. Moontrail need not catalogue them, we do sometimes. But you need go no farther than turn to a book of antonyms and synonyms. And turning to this alone, you will find, or they tell us another book called Roger's Thesaurus. We're not a lover of books, we don't often recommend them. They are dynamite in the hands of some people. You know, it is because of the danger of a pen used in the negative condition that so many negatives persist. Printed words can so mislead. For example, the holy books that we have named, the holy script, that each nation or sect of religious belief thinks is so exclusive and so undeniably the work of God. No. But there is another book, this Roger's Thesaurus, and printed lists of antonyms and synonyms. Dark, light, weak, strong, cold, warm, and so on. It's an inexhaustible list. And wherever you look, wherever you find a negative, there is always a positive. Wherever you find a positive, there is always a negative. The two-halved universe does exactly the same. The negative and positive poles of electricity are responsible for turning planets on their axes. So the negative and positive pull between the poles is, if the term is not too clumsy, the secret of the pulse beat. Indeed, we once ventured the theory. We don't know if there are any physical doctors in our presence, but we give them something to study. That the heart is not a pump at all, but an electrical coil. Think that one out. We've got a few shocks from our side when people are ready to hear them. But that's by the way. May it be possible then for us now to look at this law of opposites for a brief moment. For what purpose would you think, with your very finite intelligence, for what purpose would you think that everything was in two halves? Even you, sat there in your poor physical bodies, The negative you is being called, that's why you're here, to your positive opposite, your spirit self. Your indestructible, deathless spirit self is calling to you. Come up higher. So you come to listen to one whom you think can release a little light into the dark corners that have been made dark by the debris of decaying faiths. So, looking at this picture of opposites, the purpose must be for negatives to go to their positives and be embraced by their positives. Jesus, who trod the shores of Galilee in simple form and rose through simplicity, he didn't read the Bible, by the way. Even if it had been in existence, he read no Holy Script. He lived in tune with the phenomena of the universe and said in simple language the process of transmutation of negatives into positives when he said, "Turn thou this evil into good." As simple as that. The opposite of evil was calling to the good, and he asked you to be a cooperator and collaborator in the scheme. If there were a man gone upstairs, if there were a shred of truth in the existence of the anthropomorphic man-god, we would say that he's got a plan. We don't like using this term, he. You call God he out of the conceit of the average male. Might just as well call it she. You know that we have called it the ubiquitous it. But if there were, we would say, if you went to him and said, "What's the game, God? What's all this muddle, this suffering I have, this disappointment, this frustration, this illness, this darkness, this difficulty, this problem?" God would say, "Those are negatives, my friend. They're given you as raw material out of which you can manufacture the end product. Their opposites. I've got a big job on hand. I created this universe with negatives moving towards positives. Not steadily, but in a pulse beat, in a rhythm. And I want your help. So I put you on a very low plane of existence, imprisoned you in heavy flesh for you to learn the alphabet. I'm sorry you haven't done so. Sorry you've spent so much time in church. Sorry you've spent such a lot of time in the polling booth and the open marketplace. Sorry you've bowed the knee to Moloch. Sorry that you've let your negatives have sway to the point where you use the point of your bayonet to impale the entrails of your fellow man in war. Sorry about all that, but you must learn. You can go as long as you like, there's no hurry. Eternity isn't in terms of time. But I want to turn all imperfection into perfection by a rhythmic pulse beat. I want this pulse beat to go on, becoming less negative, more positive, less negative, more positive, less negative, more positive, until I will have completed the job. In the one word that you can understand very faintly, perfection. Will you help me?" That's the sort of thing that he, if there were a he, would say. But instead of there being that means of enlightening you, broad daylight phenomena, that doesn't mean literally so, that's a poetic term, broad daylight phenomena, clearly instructs you to watch the pattern of the universe and obey. Now, if it is true that night turns into day, turns back to night, but turns back to day, what's the matter with you at the moment with your passing trouble?